still breaks my heart that she died. I mean, very just, sad. Yeah.
What I was going to say about Moffat, like before, when Davies was watching, or running the show, I loved it, and one of my favorite TV shows, but I always still put Buffy ahead of it. Like, I always still said Buffy was my favorite. But now that Moffat's running it, and things are coming, so it's so hard, I'm almost like, okay, well, maybe Doctor Who's getting a little better than Buffy. Which, I don't know yet, because I think Buffy had, you know, 7 seasons of, in my opinion, which was a really good show. But now you have Doctor Who and Stephen Moffat running it for the past 2 seasons, and you're getting some such brilliant storytelling and things.
Oh, don't get me wrong, I love Buffy. I thought some of the later seasons were iffy.
Well, I mean, every show, I think, has its...
Yeah. Well, one thing I noticed is whenever Buffy was really good, Angel was suffering. Whenever Angel was really good, Buffy was suffering. So, I mean, I think it was just a spread a little too thin.
Yeah.
But, I mean, yeah, Whedon was brilliant, especially if also if you look at Firefly. Brilliant show. But, yeah, Moffat's amazing. Have you seen the Sherlock yet?
Yes.
I can't wait for that to start back
up. Oh my gosh. Actually, my whole family watched it. My parents and I, and it ended, and all of us were like, what just happened?
Yeah.
It's over.
A friend of mine that's a huge Sherlock Holmes fan, and he loves the older stuff, he was like, oh, this can't work. Mm-hmm. I showed it to him. He's just like, that was brilliant.
Yes.
It works so well.
No, I'm the same way. I grew up reading Sherlock Holmes.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, like, you know, when I was like 12, I was reading Holmes, and so I had this idea, and then of course they did that movie, that horrible movie, which did not deserve to be called Sherlock Holmes.
Which one?
With Robert Downey.
Okay, yeah, that was a little rough. I thought Young Sherlock Holmes was a much better film for Sherlock than I mean, it was a fun movie, but it did not seem like
it
a Sherlock
Holmes.
You know, it wasn't.
I mean, it was movie-wise, whatever. So
yeah,
that's why I was really glad when I heard that Stephen Moffat was writing it. I was like, okay, I have to watch this.
Yeah.
Please be right. But he just, I don't know. Goes back to just this, the creative storytelling he has, and the way he has to like keep characters and create characters and storylines and things that you don't really almost expect.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Moffat's an absolute genius. Literally, I'd love to meet the man.
And be like, okay, I want to just sit down and talk to you for like ever.
Yeah.
Hear what you have to say.
Give me 5 minutes, and I'll be happy with just
that. That's true. So I really hope he stays with this show.
Well, I do know this much. At least with Doctor Who, he is planning. I mean, they've already started planning the 50th anniversary.
Yeah.
So he's not going anywhere anytime soon.
And when is the 50th anniversary?
If I remember correctly, I think it's 2015.
Okay.
Is the 50th anniversary. So, I mean, he's already started working on it.
Do you think Matt Smith could really stay with it that long?
What, 3 more years?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
just based on how, I mean, even as much as we love David Tennant, he's still...
Well, you know? Tennant said if he did not leave then, he would never leave.
Yeah.
I mean, and I could respect that.
Yeah.
I mean, and honestly, Matt Smith, usually a doctor doesn't get me in his first episode. Peter Davison was on the few, in Castrovalve. I mean, I fell in love with Peter Davison in that episode. Smith did the same thing to me. When, you know, he's like, I'm done with this raggedy doctor... and he takes the clothes, and he's on the thing, getting dressed, talking to the Atroxes, and he goes through his whole speech, you know, is this world a threat, has this world broken any rules, is this world protected, and we see, like, all the monsters, and then we see all the doctors, and when he walks through it at the end of Tennant's image, and he says, hello, I'm the doctor, now run, he had me, he was a doctor.
Yeah, that was good, that was amazing.
He was a doctor for me, in that instant, because... In David's first episode, I was like, we're not getting him. It was a very Dr. Light episode, which was really strange. And then we sort of had a repeat of the first few episodes. But when we got the school reunion and the girl in the fireplace, I mean, he was a doctor. And then when they did Time Crash with Peter Davison and David Tennant...
I haven't seen that. I've heard it's really good. I know.
Sometime this weekend, I'm fixing that. I could pull that up.
I keep wanting to watch it on YouTube, and for whatever reason.
We're going at some point this weekend. Even if I have to tie you down, I'm putting it up on YouTube.
You have to watch it.
So you have to watch it because I cried. Because I mean, Peter Davison was my doctor.
Yeah.
And so when they did that, I was just. And of course, you know who wrote that?
Moffat.
Moffat.
Yeah.
That's why I can't wait to see what he has planned for the 50th anniversary. I mean, I know what I would do in it. I just can't see what he would do in it.
Yeah. That's going to be... Wow, I didn't realize. That's a long time.
Yeah. I mean, it holds many Guinness World Records now. You can actually, like, in this past 2011 edition, Doctor Who has, like, a two-period spread.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
For, like, just the number of actors who've played...
Number of actors, longest-running sci-fi TV show of all time, and now with all the soap operas leaving... You know, it may claim in time the longest running show of all time. Though, I mean, it does have to beat The Simpsons, but I know it does have The Simpsons beat already. So, I mean, it's just, Who's just amazing. I mean, Who fandom was lucky that we got a second chance. I mean, a real second chance.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, other fandoms, they don't get it. You know,
well, and for it to be such a good second chance. It's not just like they tried and everybody was like, yay, and then, okay, we don't really like... I mean, I remember reading when they were announcing Matt Smith as the new Doctor, like, they were apparently broadcasting it on screens in England. Like,
yeah.
It was a big deal.
Yeah.
And it's just so exciting to see so many people falling in love with New Who, rather than this small group of people who are just trying to hold on to it for...
And I'm so glad they're finally realizing... that their fans here in the States.
Yes.
I mean, now that we have BBC America showing it at the same time, they're importing more of the toys. You can order some of the stuff from the BBC America website now. So it's great that we're getting Who stuff here. I mean, the Who iPad game, the Who computer game. Now, if they'd only start importing the actual video games that they have over there or the Sonic Screwdriver controllers, that'd be so awesome.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think they're realizing that they do have a huge fan base over here.
Yeah. Exciting.
Yes. So while we have covered the gambit,
yes.
We actually run very long. This is probably going to be two or three episodes from here at Timegate, which I mean, I'm fine with, because whenever I get in a really good conversation with Doctor Who, I don't care how long it lasts. I mean, I'll chop it up, you know, put it into various episodes. So.
Yeah. Who's pretty good. You can talk about it for a long time.
Yes. So do you have any closing thoughts or opinions or speculation?
Well, I'll put down some, like, final, this is what I'm just going to say. I don't think the guy, person in the suit's a doctor.
Okay.
Say that. Then we can go back and be like, oh, I was totally wrong.
Yeah.
I think the girl has some relation to Amy.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know about River. Now I have to rethink River, because I never thought about her being a Time Lord.
I'll leave you with this, my final thought here. I think River is Amy and Rory's daughter. And,
Okay.
Yeah. Wrap your head around that. Because I already have. I've already figured it out.
Okay.
Yeah. Just think Peter Pan.
That's not working.
Well, in the original story, Wendy doesn't go back off with Peter Pan. It's her daughter.
Right.
And so, you know, Amy and Rory, when they do have a kid, River goes off with the doctor and falls in love with her. Yeah. You know, just another possibility. But until next time, we'll have some more stuff coming at you from Timegate, some panels and things like that. So I always hate any of these things because I never know what to say. So until next time.